Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Lorene Wilson, Sierra Staff Kennel. You know, it's a brand. It's become a brand. With everything, you know, I started and I did my, for instance, my Sierra Staff Kennel logo. And this was before anybody had logos. And I drew that, and that was of my dog. And to me, that sets the brand apart. So when people see the logo, they know what it reflects and what it stands for. A Sierra dog, to me, reflects the standard of the breed. If we were to have a standard of what I would consider to be perfection, it would be a very strong head. Because this is a head breed. This breed made their living with their mouth. And their jaws. That's what they did. Rather they were catch dogs, rather they were bull baiters in the early days, or they ended up in the pit. Their mouth and their jaws is very important. Also having good, strong, heavy bone and a good, strong rear so that they could do that job. The Sierra Staff Bloodline represents a preponderance of breed type. Sierras have more bone, more substance, more skull width, definitely a more distinct stop and a stronger, broader muzzle. And one of the things that to me I find to be integral is the strength of underjaw. Tight skin, tight lips. Because again, crushing, powerful head. We call it a punishing head. And that's what Sierra has become known to have. People recognize the type. You know, wider set eyes. That powerful jaw and that powerful head really sets them apart. Some judges felt that my dogs were pushing the extreme. Some other exhibitors and fellow competitors that did not have the bone and substance or head that we had would like to say or claim, oh, her dogs are overdone. So I got placed in that category. Oh, their shoulder, when they have shoulder muscle, they would say, oh, that's overdone. Oh, that's too much bone, too much head. When, in my opinion, it really wasn't. In my opinion, the other ones were weak. So there were a lot of people in LA, though, that loved the Sierra dogs for the breed type that they offered. And they got involved with the ABKC, and then they used my line in many of the dogs. They wanted to get some strong dogs with good substance and good bone. And they wanted to start this American Bully Kennel Club. And in the early days, they were asking me if I wanted to be part of it and be involved in that. And I declined being an AKC purist and deciding that I wanted to pursue some judging in the American Kennel Club. When you look at the American Bully, was meant to take a Sierra dog and maybe max it out even more. Because a lot of my dogs that sometimes I would breed, I would get an extreme, okay? And the extreme sometimes was not something that was maybe for the show ring, but it's something that could be added to a breeding program. So you've got to kind of understand what you've got. A more moderate dog would win more in the show ring. I've had dogs that were more of a personal favorite of mine that had more of the type that I prefer, but I knew that it would push the extreme for the judges. When you take a breed of dog and you create an extreme, and what they call extreme bullies now, sometimes sadly what you do is you lose the function of the breed. And when you lose the function, you lose the integrity of the breed. Because really, what is the breed meant to do? Form must follow function. And if the breed is not functional and they can't do their purpose or what their goal is, why breed them? What really are you trying to create? What exactly is the goal of that? You'd have to ask yourself that question and then say, well, it's got to be a functional dog. I will run my dogs and literally run them for miles. And I have been on the phone with friends and they go, oh my gosh, your dogs are panting. And they said, you know, you're really pushing them, you know, do they ever have any problem? And I say, if they do, they're not going to be in my breeding program. You need balance in a dog, front and rear. Energy transfers from the front shoulder down the top line into the rear. So you've got to have form and function. And that's like a pendulum swinging when the dog moves. And you just don't see that in the American Bullies, unfortunately. They look like pieces and parts and... It's kind of a, t- to me, sort of grotesque, monsterish looking dog that's sadly lost their integral ability to function. Trigger is out of 15-year-old semen that was stored from Titanium Tank. And Titanium Tank was a gorgeous dog. He had a following. He was pushing the extreme for sure. I mean, there were some people that claimed he was overdone, but the way that he moved, the way that he could function, when people saw him live, they realized that he had function. Because sometimes the static photos, I'm only 5'4", I'm small, and so sometimes my dogs look bigger next to me because I'm a small, petite woman. But when you take them and you put them next to a bigger person, they don't look so extreme. So to me, I can still pick up Trigger. That's important to me too. He's a bit on the large side, but I don't mind that. Standard 19 is the top of the standard. Most Amstaffs are standing much taller than that. Some people ask me, you know, was Trigger the nicest male in the litter? And I say, I don't know. He could have been the worst. He was the only one. And he is a multiple best in show dog. And the first one that we've bred that's multiple all breed best in show. Yeah, Sierra, now I've had the... been in these for 30 years, and it was 15 years with Sandra Dean before me, so I've got combined almost 45 years and of a kennel and a bloodline that's internationally recognized and known all throughout the world, and very, very famous. No matter where I go in the world, people know me. People want to, they sometimes ask me for autograph photos they can auction off at their dog club, or can I take a picture with you? And you know, it's so nice that there's fans out there that really appreciate my time and my work in the breed and really love the dogs that I've produced and love the bloodline and want to continue that. So it's my time now, as I'm moving into my retirement at some point, is to be able to make sure that good key young people have this breed and have my line and can continue it on in their own way. Because I think, you know, if something were to happen to me, what would happen to the Sierra dogs? Would it just be done and over? Or I'd like to think that I can get some new young people enthused about continuing the look. I've got frozen semen stored on a lot of my big famous dogs, and that will be used very carefully and very exclusively with people that I think are really have the right heart and the right intentions. And it's about promoting the breed and continuing the legacy of Sierra Staffs and continuing the legacy of the American Staffordshire Terrier for the way that I feel that it was meant to be bred. Strong, powerful, yet agile and graceful.